About anti-spam antibodies, I told you in one video. Today I would like to talk about another condition. It's agglutination of spermatozoids or bonding of spermatozoids. If you're interested in this subject, please continue to watch this video. I'm Dr. Lena Brazowska and I'm welcoming you on my video channel. What does agglutination mean? It's bonding spermatozoids together or with another ingredients of sperm. When doctors started to evaluate male fertility factor, they found that around 10% of men could have serious problem with conception of children. But in total, approximately 50-60% of couples could have male factor of infertility. Such tests as the sperm count or spermogram has been changed for years many times. And for the last 50 years, there are a lot of changes on what is norm and what is not norm regarding the sperm condition, including agglutination. We found that in those men who has anti-sperm antibodies, quite often have agglutination of spermatozoids. That's why doctors started to talk about immunological male infertility. But other clinical studies showed that agglutination you can see not only in men who has anti-sperm antibodies, but in those who haven't. Then doctors were telling maybe it's infection, some type of infection, or maybe it's lack of vitamin C, or deficiency of fructose, or any other deficiency. So we still don't know why agglutination occurs. But what other studies shows? In healthy men, we can see agglutination in 0.92% cases. This is very low numbers. But those men who have some problem in conceiving a child, and usually they go into reproductive clinics, in 10-13 cases, we have agglutination of sperm. So researchers start digging deeper to find out why this man have such level of agglutination. And they found that anti-sperm antibodies are not so important in agglutination, but mostly it's trauma in the past, trauma of your genital organs, including some surgical events. And I already told you that high level of anti-sperm antibodies we can find in men who had some operations or trauma, especially in scrotum area. It could be not just operation, it could be some kind of damage of scrotum and testes. So agglutination of spermatozoids also we can see more often in men who had operations. Kind of operations, it could be treatment of varicocele, hernia, or sterilization and reconstruction after sterilization, any type of operation involving testes and scrotum. Also in sportsmen, professional sportsmen who dealing with specific types of sports involving often traumatization of that area, we find more agglutination in anti-sperm antibodies. 80% of athletes can have damage of scrotum and testes, and that's why in future could have this problem. But it's interesting, despite of agglutination of spermatozoids, we don't have any treatment of this condition. What do we do then? Of course, we exclude any infection. But again, looking for chronic conditions became a commercial approach. For example, chronic prostatitis. All conditions, infection and any other condition, has to be evaluated properly and diagnosis has to be made properly. Even if you find anti-sperm antibodies and agglutination, we don't have any medication to treat this condition. Agglutination is not always a bad sign. But the problem is that we doctors, we don't have a very good guidelines what to do with these findings. That's why we need more clinical studies. If you like this video, just press like and subscribe for my channel to watch new videos that would be interesting for you. Goodbye!